Welcome back to Closing Bell. Well, let's talk about commodities now. And while, of course, with the budget round the corner, there are enough and more budget wish lists coming around. But it has been 4 to 5 years now since the GIFT City began operations as well. And there is plenty that's happening there in sense of volume, participation, and the kind of companies that are getting registered there. It is a financial services hub for sure, where you have companies, stock exchanges, banking, insurance companies as well going and getting registered. And the volumes clearly seem to be increasing. Joining us now to talk more about that is Deepan Shah from GIFT City. Deepan, hi, thank you so much for your time. The question first really is that with 4 and 5 years behind you, what is it looking like on the scorecard? Where do we stand right now? And what is still desired to be done when it comes to GIFT City? Perhaps one of the first smart cities in the 100 list that came in much later.
In terms of number of companies, we reach around 200 companies there with 9,000 people working in that city. And it is continuously on a growth trajectory in terms of more units coming in and more businesses getting registered there. However, in terms of the International Financial Services Center, we have to keep in mind that we got the business regulation issued by the Government of India in April 2015, and we got the tax clarifications and the tax incentives in the year 2016. So whereas the IFFC is concerned, we are 3 years in business now, and close to 140 companies are registered there. And for the first time, they undertake what you call international financial services all in the foreign currency, whether it is banking, insurance or capital market. These businesses were not happening in India and they have started picking up in terms of their operations in the city.
That numbers looks good, Deepan, but talking about participation, and while of course you mentioned on how banking, insurance, bonds, currencies, almost a lot of asset classes are being traded in GIFT City, and that too in dollars and other currencies, what is the kind of exact number participation and volume that the GIFT City is generating?
Yeah, I think it's important to know that the India's first international exchange got inaugurated by the Honorable Prime Minister in the January 2017. And since then, it has not looked back. It started with a small volume of 1 million per day. It has now reached close to $3 billion per day volume in that market. So there are two international exchanges operating in GIFT International Finance Center, one led by the Bombay Stock Exchange called India NX, and the other led by the National Stock Exchange called NSE IFFC. Between both of them, now the daily volume has touched around $4 billion. 140 products is what I've been able to trade there. You have got Indian stock futures in dollar, you have got cross currencies, you got gold. So you get all the products under one umbrella. You don't need separate licenses to operate. And most importantly, market operates 22 hours a day in that zone.
Right, 140 products, 22 hours a day of trading in GIFT City. Deepan, also, what would you say is the road from here now? Has it been satisfactory? Is there a budget wish list? Any policy reforms that you are looking for smart cities, especially for one like GIFT City?
See, you have to look at the International Financial Services Center from the perspective of how do we onshore the offshore activities. So over a period of time in the Indian markets, develop various businesses, create a lot of demand. But those demands are getting satisfied from whether the Dubai International Finance Center or from Singapore or from London. Why can't India more efficiently offer the similar type of the regulations and the infrastructure to do that business from India? So we created demands, we have on a platter given it to other financial centers. Now the whole, the initiative of the Government of India is how do I onshore the offshore activities more efficiently from the Indian shore. And we have seen in last 4 years of the operations of the International Finance Service Center with the tax incentives around 3 years now, we have seen 12 Indian banks doing around close to $18 billion of foreign currency transactions from that zone. And this business was not happening in India at all. So you have brought back onshore those $18 billion transactions which were otherwise been done from other financial centers. Similarly, on the insurance side, we have 17 entities operating there. Close to $30 billion of the sum insured has been returned from that zone. And you are writing dollar-denominated insurance policies from that zone, which we are used to write from the other parts of the world. So in a way, we are again onshore the insurance business, which was offshore. And on the capital market side, which is more relevant now in terms of the daily volumes and their transactions, we are seeing a lot of traction in terms of people wanting to do more efficiently the trading on the index products here from the GIFT exchanges rather than operating those products and transactions outside India.
One final question really, and what is in the pipeline now? We do understand that there is a lot of international tie-ups that GIFT City also has been able to successfully do. So going forward from here, whether it's tie-ups, whether it's more products or participation, what is the timeline and what are the targets that you're looking forward to in the years to come?
I think going forward, what we look at is in terms of the numbers, we are 9,000 people operating in that zone with 200 companies, as I said. We see a growth trajectory in terms of the number of more companies coming in. We can easily touch to around 400 companies in next 3 to 4 years. And we can easily touch a number of around 25,000 to 30,000 jobs in next 1.5 to 2 years. So that's where we are looking at in terms of expanding our business horizon. The type of the infrastructure and the buildings which have come up can easily accommodate around 50,000 jobs in that zone. And people who are operating from that zone are finding 30 to 40% operating efficiency in their day-to-day operations compared to the other parts of the world or even in from any other state that you operate today in India.
All right, those are big numbers, of course, coming in from GIFT City. Deepesh Shah of GIFT City, thank you so much for joining us and giving us all of that trades and volumes and participation that is coming out of the GIFT City at this point. But turning to commodities and